I'm Sean C. Davis, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to retrieve the ID of a Notion database using their API. Now, why is that complicated and why do we have to do it? It's complicated because even when looking at the URL, when viewing a Notion database in the browser, it seems like the unique value should be an identifying value for that database. But really, that's just for the web application and isn't the actual ID of the database within Notion's database. So we have to be able to get the ID of the database from Notion's API so that we can perform other actions on that database. And we're going to do this in a three-step process. First, we're going to create an API integration, and then we're going to connect our integration to a database, which gives us access to that database through the API. And then we'll write a really simple script that searches for all of our databases and finds the closest match, and then prints out that ID that we can take that into other scripts. Let's get started. So here's the database from which I want to get the ID. It's called Transform Notion Pages into Components. That's because this video is part in a series of videos where we're exploring that concept. So the first thing we need to do is create an API integration through Notion. If you're already inside the Notion application in any page or database, you can click on this context menu over here and then come down to Add Connections, Manage Connections. And down at the bottom here, it says develop or manage integrations. So let's click on that, and it's going to open up a new URL, which takes us to my integrations for my particular account. We'll create a new connection here, and let's give it a name. We're going to call mine maybe Notion Page Transformer. And you can clean it up and add some attributes if you like, but for this particular tutorial, all I'm going to choose are the content capabilities. I'm going to leave everything else alone. I also don't need any user information for this particular series of videos. So I'm going to leave it right there, hit submit. And after I do that, I'm taken to the detail page for this integration. And right away at the top, it gives me this secret internal integration token. Keep this around. This is the thing that we're going to need to use to be able to access the API when we're writing our Node.js script. Now, in a lot of APIs, having the token is enough to access that API. With Notion, we have to take the integration and make a connection directly to the database that we want access to. So I'm going to go back to my Notion database. Now, first, make sure you refresh the page so that Notion can bring in this new integration. Then we'll open up this menu from the top right corner again. We'll come down to Connections, click Add Connections. And if you scroll down or search, you should see the name of your new connection listed here. So go ahead and click that. Tell it, yes, confirm, I want this connection to have access to this particular database. And now we have really everything we need to be able to write some code. So let's do that. Over here, I have a really simple Node.js project. I just have an index.js file that is currently logging Hello World. And that's really it. The first thing we're going to do is install the dependencies that we're going to work with. In this case, it's Notion HQ client, which is the API client. And then I'm also going to use .env so that we can store our API token in an .env file that is not tracked with Git, so we can keep these secret tokens outside of the script. Now, to be able to add that API token as an environment variable, we are going to add a new file called .env. And then in here, we'll make a variable called Notion API key. And what I'm going to do is then go back to the integration detail page, click show, copy my key, and then come back here, paste it, save it, and then close this file. So I'm going to do that off screen for just a moment. Okay, and now I'm going to paste all the script code in here and then walk you through what's going on. The first line is just bringing in the dependency, the Notion API client. And then this line 3 here is loading the content from .env into our environment, which makes it available in the process.env object. So down here where I'm using process.env.notion-api-key, that's going to be resolved to what I just saved in my .env file. And then right here, we have just a quick little exit condition, because what we want to do when we run this script is actually provide a query that will match, or at least partially match, the title of our database, and that's the term that we're going to use to query all the databases in Notion and hopefully get back the first result. And then down here we have a single asynchronous function called getDatabaseID, and basically what it does is it calls Notion.search, it hands it the query, which again is going to be the argument that we provide it on the command line, And then it's going to filter the results to make sure that it is an object, not a block, and that the value is a database. So basically saying we're only searching database in this particular case. And then we're going to loop through all the results and we will log them to the console. You might have two databases that are named exactly the same or similar and you don't search the right thing. It's nice to just see everything in one space. And we call this function, and this is going to be the piece of the script that does all the magic. So with that, let's go ahead and run this script. So node index.js, and then we need some sort of search term. And if I go back, this is called transform Notion pages to components. You can use whatever the title of your database is. And in fact, I don't have to match the whole thing. So I might even just say transform Notion pages. And then when I search, I might get one, I might get more. I got one. So I got this exact match here, and then it gave me this ID. And so this is the ID value for that particular database. And if we notice, if I go back to the database, look at this URL I'm on, it does not match. It's an entirely different format, entirely different string, but this is the database ID. It's the value that you're going to need to use in any other query when accessing the Notion API and interacting with the database and its pages in some way. I hope this was helpful for you. And if you're watching this as part of the series of transforming Notion components into pages, then I'll see you back here for part 3.